3, 2, 1.
Hi! It's springtime, my favorite season, and I'm gonna teach you how to make les mini choux, which is tiny, tiny pâte choux filled with pastry cream, flavored with roses. You can flavor with any flour you want, edible flowers, or any fruit you want if you hate flowers, and if you think that anything flavored with flowers tastes like perfume.
Once there was a thing called spring.
And how can we dare talk about spring and happy outside? Come on, if you don't like a sunny, shiny, beautiful day filled with butterflies, birds, flowers, you don't deserve spring. Never buy flowers on a regular florist if you plan on eating them. They use a lot of pesticides to make their flowers look good in your house. They're not edible. When buying roses to eat, always choose the most fragrant ones with the darker tones. I'm gonna start by my pâte choux, which is the dough we use for profiteroles and éclairs. And a pâte choux is the only dough that is cooked and baked. In your pan, add water and butter. Cut them all the same size so they melt evenly. Add a pinch of salt and a pinch of sugar. Over medium heat, watch for your butter to melt. As soon as it melts, you're gonna add your flour and stir like crazy. Turn the heat on again and stir for one extra minute. This lovely working out process called the séchère, which is basically drying out this dough, is great for your arms, your abs, and pretty much your entire body. And the steam is amazing for your skin. No, I don't know about that. So the more you dry out this dough here, the more eggs it's gonna absorb when you start incorporating the eggs. So this is a good and very important process of your pâte choux, okay? Now in my stand mixer with the paddle attachment, I'm going to cool this dough a little bit before I incorporate the eggs so the eggs doesn't cook. As soon as there's no more steam rising from it, you can start incorporating the eggs, one at a time. The amount of eggs might vary depending on the humidity, depending on the size of your eggs, and also depending on how much you dry this batter before. I'm gonna check for the right consistency, and I want rebound stage, which means that when I lift this paddle attachment, the batter is heavy enough to pull away some of the batter itself. And also if I run my finger through it, it leaves like an open channel. That's the right consistency. Ooh, ah, ooh, ah, ooh, ah. Won't you soon bring your hips to me? Oh, bring your hips, oh, oh. My dough is perfect, it's rebound stage, like I said. And now we are gonna fill our pastry bag to make our tiny little choux. It's gonna look lovely. And if you don't have a pastry bag and you don't wanna go buy one, don't worry, just use a Ziploc bag, make a little cut on the bottom and you're fine, you're good to go. Improvise. You don't have to buy every single little thing for every single recipe you make. Cover your baking pan with parchment paper or seal pad and pipe your choux.
Quando eu vou falar, falo de você.
Moisten your fingers in water and press down the little peak.
Quando eu vou olhar, olho pra você. Penso sem parar, só em você. Você diz sim de uma maneira que até parece brincadeira.
My pâte choux is baking, and now I'm gonna make my pastry cream. And this pastry cream is a little bit richer than the pastry cream I'm used to make, simply because I wanna make it more delicious. I wanna intensify the flavor of the roses. Here I have my heavy cream. Okay, heavy cream is similar to whipping cream, if you don't know exactly what it is. That's what it is, it just changed the amount of butter fat. And I'm gonna add some sugar. All the amount of ingredients is on my website. My website is beautiful with tons of amazing pictures. Just click down here and you're gonna see all the right amount of ingredients. So don't complain about it like, oh, where are the ingredients? It's down here. And now you're gonna add the raspberry puree. Just blend or process your raspberries. Add the sifted raspberry puree to your cream and add your milk.
Say I have no use for other sweets of any kind.
Over a low heat, bring this to a simmer, very, very light simmer. Simultaneously, we are gonna blanch our egg yolks. In a bowl, add your egg yolks, sugar, and whisk until pale yellow. Add your cornstarch and whisk to incorporate. Now I'm gonna temper this egg yolk cream with my raspberry mixture, and this way we protect the egg yolks from cooking and from curdling. As soon as the cream reaches a simmer, add it to the egg yolk mixture and whisk just to temper it. Bring it back to the pan, and over medium heat, we are gonna cook it until it reaches a full boil. Then we have to cook for 3 more minutes. Every time you're using a thickening agent such as cornstarch, you have to let it boil for 3 minutes at least, or it doesn't achieve its full thickening power. This beautiful raspberry pastry cream is ready. Look at this color. If it doesn't taste good, at least it looks good. No, but it does taste good. And it smells like sweet and fruity, everything we wanted. And now we have a couple of options to flavor this with the rose flavor. So you can add rose water at this stage. You don't have rose water? Okay, because you're gonna learn on next Le Technique with me how to make rose water. Second option, you can add like rose extract. Do I add that? No, I hate extracts. Simply because most extracts have like artificial flavors, because it's easier to make it artificial than to extract from the real thing. So I wouldn't recommend you to use rose extract, but it's up to you. And what I'm gonna do here is I'm going to add this amazing rose jelly that a good friend of mine gave to me. And I'm gonna use this to flavor my pastry cream. Ooh, delicious.
I am all in a ball.
A couple of tablespoons of the rose jelly is enough. It's like one for me, one for the bowl. One for me, one for the bowl. Mmm, delicious.
Garoto genial, de barba e de bigode.
And my mini shoe looks incredible. Looks like it's baked, but we still have to dry out the interior of it. Lower your oven to 300 Fahrenheit and leave this door ajar. This is a crucial step to dry out the interior of your pâte choux. Raspberries and strawberries are from the same family as roses, so it matches really well together. And always when I use flour, I like to put some fruit with it, so it doesn't give that perfume taste like that people might hate it, and I also hate it. So I like to make the perfect balance and just extract the right amount of the flour and add the fruit to give that amazing sort of like heavenly taste. I'm going to whip my heavy cream left so I can incorporate to the pastry cream and turn my pastry cream into a creme légère. It's just lighter, airier, and it's actually my favorite filling. You don't have to do this step, but I guarantee it's gonna be one step beyond delicious.
A gente faz hora, faz fila na vila do meio dia.
Test one of your pâte choux. If it's completely dry inside, it's ready. Look how beautiful it is, super light and hollow. Using my pastry tip, I'm gonna make a little incision in my pâte choux. Slowly make the incision and pop the little piece out. If you just use a knife, you're gonna make like a moon crater in your pâte choux.
Primeira festa, o primeiro amor.
Here I'm using a filling tip, which is longer and thinner. Insert the pastry bag in the pâte choux and fill it as much as you can. Now that my little babies are filled, we are gonna make a glaze and eat each one of it. Add the confectioner sugar and the raspberry puree and make a little glaze. And this is actually a trick, because the right way to do this is by making a fondant. But if I teach you how to make a fondant by now, you're gonna kill me. Just dip your mini choux in this glaze and let it sit and get ready. Really good. I'm not just saying it because I want you to make it, it's because it does smell good. It smells like roses and, oh, maybe it's from here. No, it's from here. Roses and raspberry. I want the biggest one. This is so incredible. Oh my god. Now I know the end shadow of the doubt, it's my fault. I love the mini choux, not just because it's tiny and I love tiny things. Everything tiny, and if one day I have a kid, I will only have it because I want to see a tiny toe and a tiny finger and a tiny nose. But this choux is actually the perfect size. It's like petit four. You just eat and you don't have to bite it. You just, you know, that's it. See how you can make incredible colored food without food coloring? It's just the real deal. You use food, food is colorful, then you extract the extract the color from the food, and then you have colored food. This is my Le Mini Pâte Choux. I hope you make it and see you on the next episode of Dulce Delight. Bling!
Spring is here. I hear.
If you like this video, I'm sure you're gonna like this one here or that one. And don't forget to subscribe, check out my Facebook page, my website, where I have a brand new store launching soon, where you're gonna buy amazing stuff, and I'm not gonna tell you what, because it's a secret.